And our final competitor, ExerStories, make exercise meaningful.
Hi, everybody. I'm Melissa, physiotherapist with Homebody Health. I'm here to tell you that when movement doesn't matter, everyone pays. And I'm going to tell you a little story that's going to help this make sense. The province spends $3.15 billion a year helping people manage their chronic diseases, and yet, over the last 25 years, we're still getting sick at age 60. So we're living longer, but we're not living well. So I'll describe a patient, and I'll call him Grant, we'll just say. Grant's a retired World War II veteran. He was always very active, had a good social life. He tells me he's healthy, strong like a horse, good strong back. Takes him a while to let me know that he once was a smoker, but that's fine. There's a lot that people don't know about Grant. When his family is coming over, he hides his cane in his closet. And he'll go out shopping with them and come home so exhausted he just falls down on the couch. And you know what? He sleeps in later. His wife died a few years ago. I think he's depressed. And so, yeah, sure, my in-home physiotherapy company could come and see him and give him some health coaching and try and give him some motivation. But there has to be more options than just that. This is a web-based app called the ExerStories. And typically, if a patient like Grant were to go to a physiotherapist for guidelines, typically what they would get right now would be the how to exercise. They'd get the things in black. They'd get maybe a video or a picture of an exercise, and then they would also give him the how, the text of how to exercise. But that's not very actionable information. What I'd like to do is integrate with the home exercise programs that a physiotherapist already uses and add a little bit more value to that information package that goes home with him. So let's talk about pre-exercise instructions. Well, if he has a chronic condition, he might want to know how to safely exercise given that information. So for Grant's sake, he might want a checklist of information. In terms of risk adjustment, what we want to do is get him to the dose of exercise that makes it meaningful and makes him know he's going to get the benefit at the end of the day. So for someone like Grant, maybe we want to give him a game where he wins, whereas somebody else might have a different way of getting that reward at the end of the day. Physios also like to have standardized tests so they know that that patient's meeting the benchmarks at the end of the day. I'm positioned to test the market on a daily basis. I'm working with real patients and I'm working with other physiotherapy business owners, so I know the needs of their companies. I'm testing with patients and I'm testing with physio owners in Canada and the US. And so I really hope that all of that discovery of people's values doesn't go to waste. What I need is capital invested in the company so that I can build a really great technical team to deliver some great solutions. Thank you very much.
Questions? Okay, given your conclusion, I have to ask this question then. Are you pitching a term sheet right now?
Am I pitching it? I felt like this was a great way to kind of summarize where I exist in the market landscape because I'm providing a service. So if this is positioned as something that a physiotherapy business can use, then yes, I'm already positioned along that value chain to know how it can help the business process. Where physios can't currently offer health coaching properly, now they can. So that's a great market opportunity.
But are you raising money specifically to get those developers in-house and selling equity in your company to be able to do that? Or are you going to try and generate revenue from your colleagues in the services business to do that?
The reason why I'm a team of one is because I currently want to be very careful about who I inspire to come on to my team. So I would like to have the incentives to build a really great team. And I feel like I have the in-house capabilities to do some really great customer testing. But of course, more capital is always going to accelerate the time to market. So in my case, I'd be investing directly in my team. Like $10,000 could build a really great website, technical skills that would help me do more discovery faster.
So you're pre-angel, okay. Anybody else? Richard.
Melissa, just wondering about the actual technical part of it. What is it that differentiates what you're going to provide from other services? And Is that highly dependent upon a new technical platform, or is it a variation of what is already being done?
I'm so glad you asked that question, because I really want to make that point clear. Currently, physiotherapists don't have access to the best available information. It's still sitting on digital archives and on shelves printed out somewhere. And so it's the data is a new knowledge base for physios. But the technology is actually not new for physios, because they're already used to using home exercise software. So I'm adding data and bringing that data not only to the physios, but to the patients. And then testing in what way does that person want to get that information. Because it has to be a reward. It can't be avoiding a risk. People don't like to think about their decline, but they love to think about their potential.
Any other questions?
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.